thank you this morning in the precious name of Jesus. Lord, I bless your merciful and precious name. As we start here today, Lord, as we congregate here today, Lord, in the precious name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, we give you the honor, Lord, we give you the praises, we give you the adoration. You are Lord, you are God, you are might, you are everything to us. Lord, we lift up your name. Lord, we exalt your precious name. You are the eternal God. You are the God above everything. You are the Lord God of power. You are the Lord God of everything that concerns us. Without us, God Almighty, without you, God Almighty, there is nothing that we can do. In the precious name of Jesus Christ, of the Son of the living God. Lord God Almighty, there is no way where we can go, God Almighty, without you. In the precious name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. We lift up your name, Yeshua HaMashiach. We lift up your name, Jesus Christ. Lord, as we gather here today, this morning, in this wonderful Sunday morning, we gather here, God Almighty, at the table of shew bread to eat that which you have for us. To congregate, God Almighty, and partake of the bread, and partake, God Almighty, of the word of the Lord, and to enjoy who you are. We thank you for the revelation of Christ on a daily basis, revealing yourself to us in the wonderful and precious name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Your word is alive. Your word is power. Your word is life. Your word is the bread of life. You are the bread that came from heaven down to earth for us. You are Christ who changed our lives. You are Christ who inspired us to become all that which you are. You are Christ who is the pattern of every good work. You are Christ, the Son of the living God. You are Christ, the eternal Son of the living God. We lift up your name, Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. And we want to say this morning, Lord, let your word have, my Father, your way in us. Let your word bring, God Almighty, your will, your desire, your plans, and your purposes in us. We lift up your name, Son of the living God, and I pray this morning for every ear that is hearing this word and watching this morning, wherever they are. Father God, in personal spaces that they're in right now, I speak mercy in those spaces that God Almighty, that which is missing right now in their lives, you are God who is able to provide that. The Bible says that now unto him who is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we may ask or think. Father, we want to thank you that you are still able to show us abundant grace. There is abundant grace that you are able to show us. There is abundant mercy in you that we are able to see and experience. And I pray, God Almighty, for families that are joining us this morning. I pray, Father God, for families that are joining us this morning and all nations that are joining this morning. I pray that in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, extend your mercy, Lord, to our nations. Extend your mercy, Lord, to our beloved South Africa. Extend your mercy, O God, to our beloved Africa, to all, my Father, the nations of the world, wherein, God Almighty, there is a desire, there is a heart cry, but my Father, for the mercy of God and the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, extend that to us, glorious Lord, in the precious name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. We thank you this morning for your word. We thank you this morning for the bread of life. We thank you this morning for the breath, my Father, that you are breathing upon us. Every area in us, God Almighty, where, my Father, we are slowly going down. Every area where godly dimensions in us are being depleted and we're getting dry, bit by bit, I pray that in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, as you did, my Father, before ascension, wherein you breathed upon your disciples. Father God, I pray that, God Almighty, you breathe life to us. You breathe dimensions of God. You breathe, God Almighty, the breath of God in us, so that, God Almighty, there can be personal revival, so that spaces in us that, my Father, are getting dry and getting dead, Father God, let there be life that is being breathed in those areas. Let there be the breath of God that is being released in those areas. In the precious name of Jesus. And I pray those, my Father, that are joining us this morning who are sick in their physical bodies, I pray that God Almighty, let there be healing before we begin to teach the word of the Lord. Heal them, glorious, my glorious Father. The Bible says that the prayer of faith shall save the sick. I pray, glorious Lord, this morning, according to the book of James chapter 5, that even as we pray this morning, wherever, God Almighty, there is sickness, my Father, to those that are listening to your word this morning and to those that are joining us this morning, I pray that, God Almighty, let there be healing that is extended to them. The Bible said that the prayer of faith shall save the sick. I pray, glorious Father, for the prayer, my Father, that will expand and extend your healing grace. Let there be healing to them that are sick and joining this word this morning in the precious name of Jesus Christ. Let your word, my Father, not be heard by a sick body. Let every sickness dry up this morning. Father God, besides sicknesses, there are personal needs that people are having. Father God, in the precious name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, let every need be met according to your glory, O God. Let every need be met according to your glory, O God. You are able, God Almighty, to send ravens to take care of us, to take care of us. Send unusual people, to send stuff that your people are looking for, wherever they are. Let there be ravens like you did in the days of Elijah, where, my Father, there was an economic crisis, and you sent ravens to Elijah when he was by the brook Cherith. I pray for families this morning that are joining us. Let there be godly ravens that are sent. Let there be godly people that are sent. Send unusual people, oh God, to the pastors this morning. Send unusual people, oh God, to the believers and your sons wherever they are this morning. That in the name of Jesus, families that are cornered economically right now, I pray that in the name of Jesus, glorious Father, send ravens, unusual and uncommon people, to begin to supply the kind of things that are missing right now in the lives of your people. You are the God of heaven and the earth. You are the God of all mankind. You are the God whose voice can be obeyed by anything. When Prophet Ezekiel began to speak in the valley of dry bones responded to the voice of God. Dry bones responded to the voice of God. I pray this morning before we go to the word of God, I pray that, glorious Father, every situation right now that is, my Father, like the valley of dry bones in the lives of your people, let it hear the voice of God. As Prophet Ezekiel began to prophesy, bones began to respond. Let there be a positive response, glorious Father, in situations that are hopeless, in situations that are lifeless. Let there begin to be a process and emotion of positive response in those places and those areas. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, we pray. The name that is above every name. The name that when we call, there is an answer. The name that we are guaranteed to have answers when we call. In the powerful and precious name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, be lifted up, O God. Be lifted up, O Son of God. Out of this situation, O God, let your name receive more glory. At the end of this, my Father, lockdown, let your name receive more glory. Let there be more and more and more and more that happens to give glory to your name. I pray, glorious Father, that no weapon formed against families that are joining us this morning shall be able to prosper. No sickness will be able to cross the borders that have been made by the blood of Jesus to the lives of your people. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, I pray, oh God, I pray, oh God, that let the economic means that they use to survive, economic means where they make a living, God, let them be sustained, even in drought seasons like this, even in seasons of famine like this, even in tough seasons like this, glorious Father, sustain their means of living, sustain their means of income. Let their business not collapse. Let their companies not collapse. Let their means of income not collapse. You are the God who care. You are the God that when we call unto, you are the God who care. You are the God of love. Even in spaces like these, glorious Father, let your love manifest in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Glory, glory, glory to you, O God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Sustain churches, oh God. Churches right now, my Father, that are under serious economic attack, where, my Father, places of fellowship are almost being shut down. We pray, glorious Father, for the sustenance of your house. We pray, glorious Lord, that you will begin to send uncommon favor and uncommon people to supply the resources that are needed to sustain your house. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God, sustain your houses, oh God. All households of faith, oh God, that are feeling the heat right now in this season, glorious Father, we pray for mercy to have these houses sustained. We pray for the grace to have these houses sustained. Let no house that is legit and genuine, called of God, with the assignment of God, let it not shut down due to lack of money. Let it not shut down due to lack of rental money in the cities that we're in right now, in the nations that we're in right now, in the precious name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God. Father God, we pray that, glorious Father, sustain your houses, sustain the believers in the wonderful name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God. Let the places that we use for fellowship be sustained. Let those bills, oh God, be paid. Send dimensions of provisions. Send dimensions of provisions in the wonderful name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God. Let the burden, my Father, not affect your leaders and their families. But glorious Father, since the work we are doing is your work, let the work be sustained by the God of the work. Let the work be sustained by the God of the work. In the wonderful name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God, we pray for everybody joining us this morning, whatever space they're in right now, wherever they are right now, give them grace to be sustained in this moment. The Bible talks about Moses in the book of Deuteronomy chapter 34, that glorious Father, when he died physically, his body did not show sign of old age. I pray, Father God, for that kind of grace, that glorious Father, even in days like this, physically sustain our bodies, physically sustain our families, physically sustain our leadership structures, physically sustain the pillars of every kind of church that is represented this morning. Those that, my Father, your servants are surrounded by, who are pillars of different churches, sustain them so that, glorious Father, they don't break down and fall and collapse. Sustain them the way you sustained Moses physically. As you have sustained Moses physically, sustained us in all dimensions of life, spiritually and physically. In the wonderful and precious name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Let your name receive the glory. Let your name receive the honor. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I want you, wherever you are this morning, amen and amen. I want you, wherever this morning, just to, for a few seconds, just to thank God with me. Just to thank God with me. Just to thank God with me. Just to thank God for the grace to be sustained. The grace to be sustained. We have been sustained from day one up until now. And God will continue to sustain you. God will continue to sustain your family. I prophesy the sustenance of the Lord over you and that which is yours. Nothing shall by any means cause you to collapse. Everything concerning you shall be sustained. We just want to thank God for that. I want you, wherever you are right now, just thank God, just thank God, just thank God, just thank Him for divine sustenance. In the wonderful and precious name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, we thank you. Yes, we bless you. Yes, we give you the honor. Yes, we give you the glory. Yes, we give you the praises. We lift up your name, Son of the Living God, Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Amen and amen. Good morning, good morning, good morning, good morning. Welcome this morning to our Sunday service. We just finished prayer, and I believe that, you know, God is having something for us this morning in terms of His Word. I believe that God is having, you know, something for us this morning, and I want to believe God, I want to trust God that, you know, He will continue to show Himself as God in your life, in your family. No weapon formed against you shall be able to prosper. There is nothing that shall be able to break break you down. You are unbreakable, not by your own strength, but you are covered by God's grace. The same way he did to Moses, the same way Moses' physical body was sustained, is the same way that you are going to be sustained. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid of anything. In the wonderful name of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God, we will be looking at just a simple teaching this morning for our Sunday service, and I want to trust God that God will talk to you through this. And my heart is this, friends. My heart is this. As much as now, you know, we have been in this lockdown for quite a while now, for quite a while now, for a month actually. Now, as the church, as the sons of God, our focus now should not be surviving the lockdown, but our focus now should be channeling our wisdom, should be channeling our strength, should be channeling our thoughts and everything and our prayers towards recovery. So this morning I have a word that God has given me this morning prophetically. We're just gonna be, you know, releasing some things over you prophetically with regard to the things that are coming towards this year, as we work on the recovery. And one of the things that I want to start with is that during the week we have received an update from the Minister of Finance who was outlining the recovery plan economically for the nation, and he highlighted a number of things there that are of great interest to us as the nation. However, there is something that is very important that I want to highlight from the side of the kingdom, because one of the great benefits that God has given us, or one of the graces that God has given us as the kingdom people, is the prophetic grace. The prophetic grace is able to reveal things of the days to come. The prophetic grace gives us advanced knowledge. The prophetic anointing gives us advanced knowledge. Now, the heart of God for the prophetic is that basically all of us as sons of God should be prophetic in operations, should be prophetic in nature, should be prophetic in hearing. You don't necessarily have to be a prophet. You don't have to be a prophet, but you must be prophetic. You must be prophetic in your making, in your structures, in your operations. You must be prophetic in terms of your operations. Everything about you as a son of God must be prophetic. So we want to look at that this morning, how the prophetic will become of great benefit in terms of recovery, in terms of recovering, you know, personally, not just as the church, but you as a person, how God intend to have you recovering from this lockdown, you know, from the economic meltdown in your personal space. Very, very important and very, very significant that, you know, you grasp and understand this. So the prophetic then gives us, you know, advanced knowledge, and that is the foundation that I want to lay, so that, you know, you do not miss the foundation. You do not miss the foundation. Solomon says something very important. He speaks about, you know, the race. He says that the race is not for the strong, it's not for the swift, it's not for the powerful. He speaks about, you know, number of things that are actually human strength that should not be elements that decide certain races. And he speaks about this. He speaks about time and chance that happens to all of us. He says that the race is not for the swift, and he mentioned number of things there in the book of Ecclesiastes 9 verse 11. He mentioned number of issues there and number of things there, but he says something very important, which is what I want to start with this morning. He says that time and chance happen to all of us. In other words, a person who is born again, a person who is a sinner, a person who is a son of God, a person who knows Jesus, a person who does not know Jesus, all of us will be afforded time and chance. They will happen to all of us. However, most of the time when time and chance are given to us, you know, as sons of God, we are found wanting. We are found wanting. In other words, there are times wherein, now listen to this, there are times wherein the very thing you have been praying for a number of years, the very things you have been prophesying for a number of years, the very thing you have been declaring for a number of years, the very thing you have been praying for a number of years, you get to a position where time and chance is given to you to acquire it and to receive it, or to lay your hands into it and to get it as the answer of the prayers you've been making for quite a while. But you discover that you are unable, watch this, you are unable to acquire it and receive it and get it because you are found wanting. And we're going to look at why is it that sometimes we are unable to step into things and answers that God has answered us, but we are unable to take them. We are unable to embrace them. There are answers that you have been praying for. There are prayers you have been making for years. There are prayers you have been praying for a number of years. But the way God answers them, they will listen to this. The way God answers them, there is a condition to their answer. And one of the conditions is that you've got to be economically and financially ready to possess certain opportunities that God is opening up for you. I'm going to say this. One of the reasons why economically you must be sound and financially you must be, you must be in the right spot. I'm not talking about being loaded with massive, volumes of cash, but I'm talking about there are opportunities that you have been praying for. There are things you have been praying for. And the only way God is going to allow you to access these things you have been praying for is when in your pocket there is something you'll be able to put down, you'll be able to pay and be able to possess the answer you have been praying for. In other words, money, watch this, money is one of the tools that allows us to lay our hands on the things we have been praying for. You can pray for something, but when the answer comes, then you are supposed now to respond financially, and only to discover that no, in the pocket there is nothing that can allow you to get this answer you have been praying for, but you've been praying for it for a number of years. For example, if you have been praying for land, let me say this, if you have been praying for land and in 3 months' time an opportunity is given to you to possess that land, you are not going to possess the land by tongues, you are not going to possess the land by fire or by force, but you're going to have to pull something out of your pocket and pay for that piece of land. Well, mind you, you have been praying for the piece of land, you have been praying for this property, you have been making declarations for this property. However, when God answers, you've got to have something in your pocket to possess that piece of land. You've got to have something in your pocket to possess that piece of land. In other words, now time and chance has been given to you. Time and opportunity has been given to you. But do you have something in your pocket to respond? Watch, to respond to the time and chance that you have been given to. That's what I'm going to be talking about this morning. Now, as we move towards recovery, as we move towards the new economy that the Minister of Finance have spoken about, do you, as a son of God, do you have something aside to respond to opportunities you have been praying for? Some of you, you've been praying for number of business opportunities and types of enterprises you've got to now start. But now here is an opportunity now, as the nation is moving towards the new economy, as the church, as the son of God, are you in a position to be able now to possess these opportunities that will be opening up? Because you will not be responding to them by tongues, you will not be responding to them by prayers anymore. You will now have to respond financially to these opportunities. Watch, money allows us to possess certain answers we have been praying for. There are pieces of land you can only possess them by money. There are pieces of companies you can only possess them by money. A whole lot of things are going to be opening up as we move now towards recovery. As the body of Christ, are we right now in a position to lay our hands on certain kinds of things that will be opening? Very recently, and I will not mention a name of this place,
But very recently, we have heard this. Before I read my scriptures, we have heard that there is a particular casino, there is a particular hotel that will be shutting down, and they will not be returning to business. You know, in one of the areas in our nation, in one of the provinces in our nation. However, now as they will be shutting down, they've got a huge piece of land, they've got a huge piece of building, they've got a huge piece of property. Are we right now as sons of God to be, are we in a position right now to go into that piece of land and lay our hands into that piece of land and possess a piece of land that will enable us to do the assignment of God on planet Earth with simplicity? Watch now, when opportunities like that are opening up, you know, are we right now in a position as believers to possess this kind of industry, to possess this kind of, you know, factories that will be opening? Some factories will not be retaining, some companies will not be retaining. Are we as sons of God who have been confessing dominion, you know, for a number of years now, we have been singing about dominion, we have been prophesying about dominion, are we in a position to lay our hands in these properties, in these pieces of land, in these companies? Are we able now to get them? Because this is what you have been praying for, this is what you have been dreaming of, this is what you have been prophesying. Now the issue here is this: some dreams will not necessarily, you know, end up in just being dreamt of. Some goals will not only need you to dream of them, you're gonna have to have stuff in place and money in place to lay your hands on some of these opportunities. So we are going to look at this, and our scripture this morning is the book of Jeremiah 32. We are going to read the book of Jeremiah 32, and I want to prepare you for recovery. I want to prepare you for recovery, and the Lord spoke to me this morning, about recovery, and I want to prepare you for recovery. But before we get into issues of recovery, I want to say this. Now, when you carry a particular kind of anointing, you must also be a beneficiary to that particular grace. You cannot carry the grace of healing and be found sick. You cannot carry the grace of healing and you, the carrier of the grace, you are literally sick to a point of death. I'm not saying that you can't be sick, but I'm saying part of what you also need to enjoy and experience, you know, as a grace carrier, is to be in a position where the grace you carry also works for you. I've got a problem with an anointing that only helps others. Yes, I understand we are anointed not for ourselves only, but we are anointed for others. However, if you carry the specific grace of God in your life, that grace must also help you. You can't carry grace that whose effect and impact is absent in you. When you carry a particular measure of grace, that grace must also benefit you. When you carry the prophetic grace, that grace must help you. When you carry the grace like that of Solomon, that grace must also help you. When you carry a particular kind of grace and anointing, it must also benefit you. You can't carry a grace that is absent, you know, in your life. That grace must also manifest its glory in your life. In other words, my life must be in a position where in the dynamics and the dimensions of the grace that I carry are also evident in me. In other words, if I carry a particular kind of anointing or grace in my life, and the impact and the effect of that grace is evident in my life, I become now a model and a pattern of that grace. In other words, when grace starts to benefit the carrier as well, that carrier becomes a pattern and becomes a model of what that grace is all about. Let me say this as we read our scriptures. We are reading from the book of Jeremiah 32. I want to say this before I read my scripture. The grace you carry must be evident in your life, not just in the lives of others. The grace you carry must also be evident in you. If it is healing, we must also see you getting into places and positions where, you know, literally you get healed out of it. If it is the grace of wisdom, We must see it evident in your life. So these graces we carry must be evident in our lives. So you become a beneficiary. You personally benefit. So I wanna put that now, the background of where we are going to read. We are reading about Jeremiah as a prophet. Now let's see what grace does when grace, you know, is sitting upon a person. Jeremiah, the book of Jeremiah 32, we are going to read from, you know, from verse 6. And scripture say, "And Jeremiah said, the word of the Lord came to me, saying, behold, Hanamel, the son of Shallum, your uncle, will come to you, saying, buy my field, which is Anatot, for the right of redemption is yours to buy. Verse 8, then Hanamel, my uncle's son, came to me in the court of the prison according to the word of the Lord and said to me, please buy my field that is in Anatot, which is in the country of Benjamin, for the right of inheritance is yours and redemption yours. Buy it for yourself. Then I knew that this was the word of the Lord." This is Jeremiah saying. He says, God says to him that somebody is going to come to you with a piece of land that they will offer to you to buy. And when they offer it to you to buy, please buy it, please buy it, please buy it. And then the man came to Jeremiah to say, you know, this is a piece, his cousin, I've got a piece of land, I want you to buy this piece of land, and you know you are in a space and in a position where you are able to buy. Now the first thing that I want to establish here before we go very far is, number one, God knows, listen to this, God knows your buying capacity. God knows your buying capacity, and therefore, listen to this, He will never reveal to you what to purchase and what to possess if you are not economically in a position to possess it. I want to say that again. If you are not in a position right now to buy a factory that has gone out of business and you are financially unable to do that, God will not reveal some of these things to you, because God knows where the next economic boom will happen, where the next economic, you know, surge of things will happen. So He does not reveal it to you if you are not in a position and you don't have the capacity to economically purchase these opportunities. He comes to Jeremiah. He says, "Jeremiah, I know the capacity of your account. I know the capacity of your finances. You are able to buy and purchase a specific piece of land. So therefore, there is an opening in terms of land that is coming, and I want you to buy that piece of land." So God cannot reveal to us, you know, the next economic boom if we are not in a position to financially lay our hands into such kind of things. God does not reveal to us what our capacity is unable to do. God cannot reveal to you what your economic capacity is unable to possess. So Jeremiah was in a position financially to possess the piece of land that his uncle will offer. So God does not, I want to say this again, God does not reveal to us what financially we are unable to purchase. So if financially you are not in a space where you cannot possess, you know, a casino or a building of the hotel or a casino which is now running out in terms of business, which is not going to return after lockdown, such kind of things will not be revealed to you. In other words, when you are financially stable in a space, in an area where you are able to possess these things you have been praying for. Remember, some of these things you have been praying for them. Some of these things you have been declaring them. Some of these things you have prophecies hanging over your life concerning them. But when they become available, you know, are you not surprised that you just get surprised that somebody else next to your city has just bought exactly what you were declaring? It is because at times we are not having the capacity to possess such kind of things. So when there is no one amongst us who is able Bible, God does not reveal these kind of things. I don't want to be in a position where time and opportunities, you know, passes me because financially I'm not stable or I'm not in a position to can lay my hands on what I've been declaring, what I've been prophesying, what I've been praying for. I don't want to be in that position. However, Jeremiah was in a position to purchase this piece of land. And he says, Jeremiah, he says, then I know this was the word of the Lord. God is able, watch this, God is able to reveal to us where opportunities are, provided if we are economically in a state and position to possess those opportunities. God is able to reveal to us through prophetic faculties the next industries that will be booming in Africa, that will be booming globally, provided if we are in a position as sons of God to lay our hands on such. Now we don't have to be waiting for, you know, market analysts and economists who are going to tell us what is the next big thing coming. When we have the prophetic dimension in operation in our midst, we are able to know in time ahead, in advance, the next industries that will be booming. However, do we have the capacity to possess such industries? God says to Jeremiah, there is a piece of land I want you to possess. Why? He knew the capacity of the man he's talking to. God does not talk to you economic opportunities you don't have the capacity to possess. God does not reveal to you economic opportunities you don't have the capacity to take. If you don't have the capacity to take certain opportunities, God tells them to others who are able. And the tragedy is this, is that when there is no one in the church who is able to listen to these and who is able to capture these, somebody who is not even of God will capture the frequency outside the church and be able to lay their hands into this with other means. Because when God has Father help us. Help us. He does not reveal to you opportunities you are unable to possess. You can only get a revelation of economic opportunities you will possess. As we move towards recovery, some of you, you've got, you know, economic resources that have not been used up until now. My plea is this with you. Please do not squander the resources that you have not been able to use for the last 30 days. Do not squander your bank account right now. Do not squander your bank account with unnecessary things, because God will be beginning to speak to you in the context of your bank account, because things will be opening up. I want to say this, and this is what the Lord spoke to me this morning. He spoke to me this morning to say that which is remaining in your account, that which is remaining in your pocket, do not squander it now, because I'll begin to resonate things in your ears concerning that which your account is able to possess, like I did with Jeremiah when he wanted Jeremiah to possess the piece of land. God did not just do that magically. He knew the capacity of the pocket. So the capacity right now of your pocket, whatever is remaining right now, I want to prophesy you, whatever is remaining right now in your pocket, don't waste it, because the voice of God is coming in the context of what is in the pocket. There are opportunities equivalent. Watch. There are opportunities equivalent to what is remaining in your pocket. Do not squander your resources. Do not squander your savings. Do not squander your financial capacity. You are about to possess certain industries. You are about to dominate certain spaces. Now, if you squander it recklessly, you will be unable to possess that which will be opening up for you. There is the voice coming from the throne right now that will be speaking to you with regard to market opportunities that will begin to open up. And it is time that now the church gets into the place of dominion. I thank God for revival. I thank God for the healing of the sick. However, we also need now as a church to be positioned economically so that we are in a position where we are able now to dominate as we are supposed to. Thank God for healing of the sick. Thank God for casting out of devils. But when we are done with casting out of devils, we've got to be owning industries. We've got to be leading, you know, spaces economically. We've got to be captains of industry. It's time for the church right now to rise and get to that place of dominion and dominating. And we are going to do that through the prophetic anointing and the capacity of our pockets. Allow God right now to allow to be restrained right now. Allow to be restrained to spend. Refrain from spending unnecessarily, because God will be speaking to you right now with regards to what he did to the man Jeremiah. And he revealed to Jeremiah places and things to buy. There are things that God will be talking to you right now with regard to your financial capacity. Be prepared to possess what you have been praying for. Be prepared to possess what you have been prophesied about. Be prepared to possess what you have been declaring in line with your financial capacity. It's time that the church now, we need to forget about, you know, when people talk about, you know, laying hands on the sick and all of that, they always, you know, talk about the church and revival and all of that. It's okay, but that is one priestly aspect. There is an economic aspect right now that the church need also to be part of it. We need to be part of it. As new economics open globally, there must be sons of God who are going to sit in those spaces, who are going to sit in those, you know, industries and possess. But are we in a position where economically we can possess this kind of things? Whatever is remaining right now in your pocket, don't squander it. It's going to be your ticket to possess what you've been praying for. It's going to be your ticket to possess what you've been declaring. The time has come and the time is now. I want to read again, from verse 9, Jeremiah 32 from verse 9. Number 2, Jeremiah 32 verse 9. So I bought the field from Hanamel, the son of my uncle, who is in Anatot, and weighed out of him the money, 17 shekels of silver, 17 shekels of silver. And I signed the deed and sealed it, took witnesses, weighed the money on the scales. So I took the purchase deed, both that which was sealed according to the law and the custom, that which was open. And I gave the purchase deed to Baruch, the son of Neriah, the son of Mahesiah, in the presence of Hanamel, my uncle's son, in the presence of the witnesses who signed the purchase deed, before all the Jews who sat in the court of the prison. Then I charged Baruch before them, saying, "Thus saith the Lord host, the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, take these deeds, both this purchase deed which is sealed and this deed which is open, put them in the earthen vessel, that they may last many days." Watch this, verse 15. "Thus saith the Lord of hosts, God of Israel, houses and fields and vineyards shall be possessed again in the land." Houses and fields and vineyards shall be possessed again in this land. God spoke to the man with financial capacity, who was a prophetic voice of the nation, to possess a particular piece of land. And the man of God prophesied and said, houses, economic activities will continue even after the meltdown, even after the depression, even after the pandemic. Economic activities will continue. There will be a new economy that rises out of this. However, as sons of God, we've got to be in a position where we will be in charge of certain houses. We will be in charge of certain fields. A field is a means of economy. A field is a place of production. A field was a place where people will plow. It was an economic means of the Jewish people, and vineyards. So God says to this man of of God, houses will be sold, vineyards will be sold, and fields will be sold. So you've got now to be in a position where the new economy rises and the new economy, you know, opens up. You've got to be in a position where you are already having your hands laid in some of these things. Don't squander resources that you have right now. Don't squander your savings that you have right now, because it's going to buy you a house. It's going to buy you a field. It's going to buy you, you know, a vineyard. It's going to be buying you things. These are the things you have been prophesying. There are industries that will be up for sale. There are lands that will be up for sale. There are buildings that will be up for sale. There are properties that will be up for sale. Are you, as a son of God, are you going to miss some of these things? Because these are tools that will give us dominion as the body of Christ. Thank God for this pandemic, because when it is done, a new economy will rise. We are not going back to the old order of things. We are not going back to the old way of doing things. However, as the church of God, let us not be left speaking in tongues and miss these great opportunities. Let us not be left, you know, shouting fire and miss these great opportunities. God's power and God's hand, God is crossing the hands. God is crossing the power. God is crossing, you know, power shift. And one of the ways in which it's going to happen, he will be whispering to some of you the kind of things to possess, the kind of places where you need to invest. Don't invest anywhere. I'm warning you. Don't just invest anywhere. Wait for the direction of the Lord, because where things will be going, only God knows how things will unfold. But as prophetic people, you are in a place of advantage. You are in a position of advantage. If you pay attention, you will know where things is going. If you pay attention, you will know. You will be the first ones to know what is about to happen. Don't destroy your financial capacity, because your financial capacity will be helping you to get into a position, to get into a space where you will lay hands on, you know, economic means of production. Economic means of production shall be owned by the church. I want to prophesy some of you right now that a time has come, and a year is 2020, where you will own means of production. You have been prophesied about means of production. You have heard clearly from the Lord about certain industries. It's time that you start to move towards there. Don't hesitate. Jeremiah did not hesitate. Jeremiah did not think twice when God spoke to him about it. My friends, let me tell you right now, when God economically start to speak to you, don't squander resources. Move towards where God is talking to you about. Invest where God is telling you to invest. Don't wait for market analysts. Don't wait for other people to whisper to you. Wait for the voice of God, because God knows what is best. A season and a time has come for us to rise into a place of dominion. A year to possess things. A year to come to a place of dominating. And the time is now. But the ticket is your financial capacity. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Father, help us. Help us, Lord. Help us in the mighty and precious name of Jesus, because power is changing hands. Help us in the mighty name of Jesus. There is a shift that is taking place right now. Those that were slaves are now coming to place of kings. Those that were living as slaves, God is going to cause them now to come to places of power, to come to places of dominion in the mighty name of Jesus. A season of your shift has arrived. A season of your shift has come. Are you prepared and are you ready for it? In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, God is getting ready to cause you to become a captain of a particular industry. Some of you, you will not be returning to work. You will be returning to your own work. You will be owning a particular industry. You will be leading a particular industry, because you have heard clearly from God. When God started to resonate in your ears where things are going, you paid attention and you listened. And as you respond, your pocket also enabled that to happen. Don't destroy your pocket right now. Don't destroy that which is remaining in your account right now. Don't destroy your financial capacity, because it's going to allow you to respond to the voice of God. One of the reasons why we need money is to respond to the opportunities that will be opening up. There are so many opportunities that will be opening up, but are you ready to respond to them? You're not going to respond to them by tongues. You're not going to respond to them by shouting. You are going to respond to them financially. You are going to respond to them by your pocket. If your pocket is unable, you'll remain a slave. If your pocket is able, your time has come to dominate. Your time has come to get to that position where God, from day one, He has wanted you to be in that position. I release this right now upon your life. Everything in your ears that has been disturbing you to clearly hear from God, let it be removed so that you can now clearly hear the sound of heavens. You can clearly hear God resonating in your ears. In the wonderful and precious name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, you will be accurate in hearing. You will be accurate in investing opportunities. You will be accurate in terms of knowing which way to go. The steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. Some of you have been waiting for such a time as this, and Jehovah is ready to order your steps. I pray that in the name of Jesus, let Him order your steps. Let Him order your financial steps. Let Him order your financial steps. And as many as they are led by the Spirit of God, these are the sons of God. God does not only lead us in terms of church activities. He also wants to lead us economically. He is saying, I'm ready to lead you economically. Are you ready to follow His steps as He began to lead you economically? There is a place where there will be money. There is a place where there will be power. There is a place where industries will be up for sale. He wants to lead you to such places. The steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. He is going to lead you economically. He is going to lead you to where you invest. You are not going to invest on fly-by-night things where you are robbed and cheated of your resources. But God will want to lead you and order your steps to sound things that you will carry the title deed for. You will know that this is God. The Bible says, Jeremiah said, I knew that this is God. I pray that such moments begin to come to you. I pray that such moments begin to come to you where you will know that you were directed by the Lord. Some of you will be moving out of your city to a completely new city because you have been led. I pray this morning as I close, let Jehovah order your steps. Let Jehovah order your steps. Some of you, my pastors, you have been praying for a piece of land, and I hear the Lord saying, land will open up. I hear the Lord saying, land will be available, but do not squander the resources in the church account right now, because you will be immediately after this pandemic, you will be having enough to pay for that piece of land. There are buildings in your city that will begin to be ready and available. You have been praying for that building, and Jehovah says, I'll be directing you to what to buy, what to possess, and what to invest upon. Yes, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God, some of you who are already owning your businesses, you were already running industries, there's coming expansion. The Lord will begin to order your steps to where to expand to. You are not going to expand to where everybody is expanding to, but yours shall be the expansion of the Lord. Days of expansion are here. Days of expanding are here. Days of expanding are here. And you will be having the capital to expand. God says, don't waste the capital you have right now. You were having something and you were not so sure of what do I need to do with what is in my account. What do I need to do with what I have? Do not squander it. That is your capital to your days of expansions. God is going to put you in the place of expansion. Days of expanding are here. Lord, order my financial steps so that I don't waste resources that I will need as a Jeremiah to respond to land, to respond to properties that are available, to respond to vineyards that are available. There are running vineyards right now that are bearing grapes, full of vines that are running right now. They will be up for sale. I pray that in the name of Jesus, when such opens up, God will begin to direct you, and you will be having the capacity to be able to do that and lay your hands upon it. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God, the days of economic slavery are over. Days of economic slavery are over. Days of begging are over. Land owners will rise in the church of God. Business owners will rise in the church of God. You know, property owners will rise in the church of God. Vineyards owners will rise in the church of God. Vineyard owners will rise in the church of God. You will own houses more than the house you are staying upon. You will own houses which you will derive rental income from. You will start to own properties. You will start to own properties, not by cheating others, or not by, you know, not by cheating and robbing others, but God will begin to be directing you which way to go, which way to go. It's not going to be a miracle. It's going to be, you know, a process out of your capacity that God is leading you to. House owners, more than one, more than two, more than three, four properties, five properties. Vineyard owners, land owners, arising as we recover. Don't squander what is remaining. Don't squander that capital. Don't squander what you have right now. That is going to be the ticket for you to own, and the ticket for you to buy land like Jeremiah. In the precious name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God. And I hear him saying, what you have been praying for, what you have been declaring, what you have been waiting for is going to be available for sale. Be prepared to purchase it. And don't ignore the laws. Don't ignore the admin that needs to happen. Because after Jeremiah purchased the piece of land, he administrated the process in the manner which the process must be administrated. Don't ignore the laws that needs to be adhered to. Don't ignore the rules that needs to be adhered to. In other words, as Jeremiah bought that piece of land, he was also aware of the laws involved around it, and he played within the laws involved. I want to advise you that some of these houses, some of these vineyards, some of these pieces of land, when they open up, know the regulations and adhere to regulations. The fact that, you know, it has been, you know, provided for by the Lord does not mean you must ignore the laws and the regulations of the land. You know, play within those regulations and ensure that, you know, in every piece and in every part of legislation, you are covered and you are not in trouble with the agents of the law. In the precious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ of Nazareth, opportunities will be opening up. Time and chance will be offered to us, so long as our economic means and capacity is able. Just like Jeremiah, God revealed to him what he was capable of possessing. God does not reveal to you what you are unable to possess. In the precious name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God. God bless you. Have a lovely, lovely, lovely Sunday morning. And I will see you in the evening when we come back to do the evening teachings and the evening session. The Lord really bless you so much. The days of begging are over. These are the days to own. These are the days to possess. These are the days to lay our hands on that which we have been waiting for and praying for. In the precious name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.